Hi guys, this is Spud, and today I am going to be taking a look at Minecraft Dungeons with you. But there is first an intro video that I would like to show you. So without further ado, let's get started.
It was a time of great adventure and danger. Shunned by his kin, an illager wanders the land, seeking a new home. But all he found was hatred. Driven by rage against those who wronged him, he wandered blind to whatever end. Until at long last, the illager found something that would change him forever. The Orb of Dominance. Corrupted by evil, driven by vengeance, the Arch-Illager made all bow before him. And if they did not bow, they would fall. The Illagers raided the land. Who would have the valor, the purity of heart to stand against the Arch-Illager's reign of terror? Well, not that one. Maybe you.
Okay then, so that's the intro video. But I think that we should just hop straight into the game as this mustache guy. So start up a game and go. So first we'll be doing the tutorial, which is Squid Coast.
The village is burning. No doubt this is the work of the evil Arch-Illager and his minions. They sweep across the land like a ravenous scourge, subjugating or destroying all in their path. This is a time for heroes like yourself. Make haste. The villagers have need of you.
So to start things off, we're just going to go around here and find a secret that I've just seen. I saw a secret girl actually. And now I have some emeralds, shadow brew, and TNT. If I roll over there, roll over here, throw the TNT, I might just throw it in, kill him. Nope. So I might as well just go and slice him. Run up here. Nice, that zombie. Up here, I might just go slice, and kill all of them guys. There's nothing that I can get over there. Run over here. Some arrows, and shoot that guy. Shoot that skeleton. Can't get something fire yet. Fire bullets. I like it, doesn't look like it's burning all there. Pretty cool. And over here, destroy that zombie. Get the turn of the zombie and that zombie. And slice. And keep slicing and dicing. Vindicators, repair them easily. Well, the supply chest, I'm just gonna head round here, which is a secret. And there we go. Secret chest. It gives me a ton of emeralds, which is nice. In the supply chest, I'm gonna get some bread and some arrows, which is always nice. There's nothing I can do around there. So I'll just head around here. It's pretty straightforward, this map. There's no big twisty turns or anything. Just sort of go this way and go that way. So it won't be too difficult if you're doing this yourself. Alright, there's the archer here. Gonna chuck some locusts. Vindicator, sorry, at us. Now I've got a level up, so now I can enchant my gear, and I might enchant my bow, and I might get infinity on it, because I do not want to be running out of arrows anytime soon. What infinity actually does is that it gives a chance to immediately replenish an arrow, so we will still use arrows, otherwise it would be a bit overpowered. Gonna select the firework arrow and just shoot the guy. Blue explosion. Can I have that emerald, please? Emerald. Now roll over to this chest. Open that up and get a bundle of arrows. Come up here, make sure I have checked absolutely everything. Which I have. Just need to destroy him, and then we're good to go. We are basically at the end of the tutorial now, and there is nothing else that I know of around here. So the only thing really left to do is just complete the mission, like so.
You were too late to rescue the villagers, but don't fret. They're still out there somewhere waiting for a hero to find them.
I opened all the chests, and there we go. So now I open this big chest up here, and you have one of these at the end of every level, and it contains four artifacts. This time I got a fishing rod, which does that, and it allows you to stun enemies. So, at the camp, there is really just some training dummies that you can practice on. And there's also a little tavern here, and different things get added to the tavern as you complete different levels, which is cool. And so at the map, if you go to the map, then it will come up a map of all the levels that you can do, which is pretty cool. So I'm just going to head over to the map table and go to Creeper Woods. And you know what, I might rank the difficulty up to 2. The recommended power is 4 and I only have 1, but there will only be some starter enemies, so it shouldn't be too hard. Let's give it a go.
By the Arch-Illager's decree, all free folk are now enemies of the Illager Empire. Somewhere in these woods, a caravan is transporting villager prisoners to labor in far-off lands. Find the caravan and stop the Illagers, or there's no telling what dreadful doom will befall our villager friends.
Okay then, So from this level up, then there will be armored zombies, as you saw there, and there are there. And the armored zombies, they do more damage and they're tougher to defeat. A bit of shadow proof on there so I can be a bit invisible. Bam, 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 and bam. Don't get over here. Chop these guys up. Got a bit of hunter's armour. Quickly going to equip that, and that looks like a really good piece of hunter's armour actually. I'm going to check it out just after I've defeated this horde of zombies. And then, so it gives plus 24 health. Has plus 30% ranged damage, so it'd be better off using my bow on this guy. And it gives plus 10 arrows per bundle. So as you can see now, well, I might as well do that. So now at my full health is now 124, instead of if I had no armor at all, then it would only be, wait, no, let's actually take it off this time. As you will see, it only be 100. So I'll put this armor on, and it's now 124, which is handy. And get him, check around here, another emerald pot. Is all nice. Bam and bam. That gets him. Gets him. That gets him. And that gets him. Free him and destroy the skeletons. Got some apples to generate my health nice and quick. Excuse me. I don't think you're allowed to shoot me. For this different route over here, just because I could end up getting some even better treasure. I have got arrows all over my face. And jam, jam, bam, bam. I've just leveled up now, so I should be able to enchant another piece of gear. I might enchant my armor snowball, because I have had snowball before and it is very useful. And that's what that white thing is there. I've been thinking trying to use that. And dandy. Head up here and roll around. Try and just check this little tunnel bit. Collect all of that. Like so. See this. There's the pressure plate. And that should open up. Hey, nice new bit of area. As you can see there, but I do notice from the map that I haven't fully explored all of that. So I'll go and do that and then come back over to the area that I was at. There we go. Chest with some hunter's armour. It's not as good, that hunter's armour, so I might just sell it. Into there. A new location. our secret level, which is Creepy Crypt. Did you see the guy got stunned there? And that was my snowball. I have a bit of TNT. That's a really good bow there. It's got 2 enchantment slots. I think I should get power on it. And then I could also get another enchantment on it. Since it has 2 slots there to enchant items. Ooh, shot through. I do quite prefer infinity. Sword is better, so I might as well go and equip that. There's no reason why not. And there is an absolute ton of zombies over there. And it's a fireworks arrow! But there is still a whole ton of area that we have not explored yet. See? Tons of zombies over here. Get all of them in that arrow bundle. Make sure there's nothing in here, which there is not. And stunned, bam. Open this, I get an arrow bundle, strength and swiftness potion. That's all nice and lovely. Now we better go and check all of that area over there now. It is quite a big level, this. With creep woods. That did not work. Meant to roll over there, but turns out I didn't. Right, fell right off into the abyss. Wrong way. Gotta go this way. Turn the map off, it'll probably get quite annoying for you, actually. You guys. Go and explore just that little area over here. Bam, bam, wham. Enjoy open. Shift this potion. Explore all of this. Nothing there. Let's go and check. Yep, that is everything explored. So I can now head all the way over here. And come out of this place. And now I am on the other side of the level where skeletons are trying to kill me. And I will kill them. Ah! Sorry about that. So, head over here. Smack all of them in the face. Check all of this. Drink a potion, why not? Shoot these skelly bones. There's nothing. So let's continue on over this way. Make sure everything is nice and explored, so we know everything and where everything is. Walk over here. That creeper. Check that there's nothing over here. And there is not anything over there. Go this way. I'm supposed to go this way. So we can go and get all the loot from here if there is any. Well, there is that, and oh, what is this? Oh, it's another big crypt area. This looks really, really big. I don't think I've actually seen this before. But we might as well explore it anyway. Okay then. I don't know why I was trying to shoot you through a wall, but okay. Get all that stuff. Villager statue there. Of emeralds. And lovely. Lovely job there. I'll collect all of the treasure from in here. Secrets found. 3 of 5. That's 5 secrets. Okay. Let's go and see if we can find all of them then and get all the chests. It says there are 8 chests in this level. That and across over here. That leveled up. Should be able to enchant my sword. Make a weakening on it. Sounds good. Head back over here. Get all of them. Take out all of these guys. Pot of emeralds. Hear those vindicators. There's a vindicator. Got him. Just got this bit and then we're gonna have to go and head out now. Okay. Not mean to do that, there was was no point in throwing it there. I will not say no to some more arrows. Nice big loot chest there. Hunter's armor and some arrows. I don't particularly need the armor, so I might just go and salvage that. A tiny bit more around this corner. Head around here, make sure there's nothing. Well, there is a corridor, it's a room. I seem to have gotten everything by the looks of things. All area explored. Now, all there is to do now is to go and find the exit, which is just over there. Here we are, here's the exit. And then just go and continue on the level. And we've come out here. Right, we've got to go down this way now. And here is a pot of emeralds. There is nothing else around here at all, so just head forwards. We'll take that bread. Go and shoot everything. Zombies everywhere. Head across this bridge right here. The emeralds, and just go and get the tiny area over there, just so it's marked as, yep, I've explored that. Shoot that skeleton, shoot that one, that one, that one, that one, and that one, and there is bound to be some more. Tons of spiders there. Let's go in here and grab these supplies. Smash open these faces. And go and mark all of that area off the list. and shoot all of these spiders. No dancing spiders allowed. Head over here. Fancy chest. Got a sword and some TNT. That sword, let's have a check. It does more damage. I shot than stunning and rampaging. No, gonna get rid of that one and sharpness on. I think sharpness is better. I would prefer sharpness. Right, tasty bone and the sword, that's no good. Open that vase. Go over here, open that vase. Chest over there. TNT swiftness potion and a ton of emeralds. In here. Oh, guys, everybody. Ooh. Did not mean to do that. Nearly blew myself up there. No use. Come back here and free this guy. I really like that grass there. Check the map. Gotta go around all of that cove. And then we can have this. Finished mission. Run over here. I don't know why that pressure plate does anything, because it's supposed to undo something when you have completed the game. I have, but definitely not on this character, because you saw me just create it. Create this character. The supply chest, arrows and some bread. I now have 730 arrows. It is an awful lot. Check the map. Yep, just that little bit up here to go. We should, in theory, have nearly finished the mission. Got an achievement. Om nom, make 200 food items. That's quite good, that. Cover that up. Destroy him, destroy him, destroy him. All these spiders and me. Got a bow. I'm going to check that bow as soon as we've killed all the bees. Is no good. Oh yes, I can enchant this, can't I? Get supercharge on it. and it deals more damage, and it will deal even more damage now when I supercharge it. That's 50 damage, and that's not going to be the highest. Area, there probably won't be anything, but we might as well check just in case. Okie dokie, it looks like there's nothing there, but there are some spiders here. Okay. Right, now I can see myself. Got that apple, got them. Come through here. Destroy the enchanted boots. Get my dog. Get them guys. And this looks like the end to me. TNTs. Dog, don't go in there. Oh, that's nice. I have arrows all over my head. That wolf armor is pretty good. Really good, in fact. So I'm going to put snowball on that now. Potion. And finish the mission.
These villagers are free from the clasp of the illagers. All thanks to you.
There we go, that was Creeper Woods and the tutorial mission all in one episode. But unfortunately, it does look like it is time to end this video. But first, just got to open this chest. I now have a death cap mushroom and I might switch that out for the fishing rod. Ooh, look, a chest. A chest full of emeralds. That's nice. And you can also trade with these guys. But, yep. Does look like that this is now the end of the video. So I hope you enjoyed watching. And I will see you next time. Bye! Thanks for watching. Please could you like and subscribe. And until next time, keep on spudding!